Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel Shraddha's Physics. In this video we will see some MCQs, that is the important MCQs for the BSc students, and here we will discuss on the magnetic properties of the matter. So let us start with our first question. Which of the following substances are the dielectrics? Copper, germanium, mica or tungsten? So here the correct answer is mica, that is it is a dielectric material. The next is the center of gravity of positive and negative charges, they coincides in H2, CO or HCl or H2O. So the correct answer is H2, that is the center of gravity of positive and negative charges, they coincides in the hydrogen molecule. Since I have already been discussed about the polar and nonpolar molecules, so we are not going in further detail in that. So the next question is the relation between three electric vectors, that is E, D and P, that is electric field, electric displacement vector, and this one is your polarization vector. The relation between these three will be D equal to epsilon naught E vector plus P vector. Okay, D, that is your displacement vector, equal to epsilon naught electric permittivity into electric field vector plus P vector, that is your polarization vector. The next question is the relation between the dielectric constant K and the dimensionless electric susceptibility chi e is k equal to 1 plus chi e. That is the dielectric constant K will be equal to 1 plus the electric susceptibility. The next question is the unit of epsilon naught is. So here the epsilon naught is the electric permittivity. So the unit will be Fermi meter inverse. Okay. The next question is the unit of relative dielectric constant is. So the unit of relative dielectric constant is, it is the dimensionless, so it has no unit. The next question is in D equal to epsilon naught E vector plus P vector, P is connected with free charges only, bound charges only, free and bound charges both or none of this. So here in case of D equal to epsilon naught E plus P vector, that is this polarization vector, it is connected with the bound charges only. Okay. Then the next question. In general, the effect of the temperature on relative permittivity of a material is to reduce it, increase it or maintain it or all of the above. So in general, the effect of the temperature on relative permittivity of a material is to, it is to reduce it, increase it and maintain it. That is, the all of the above is true. That is, it may reduce or it may increase or it may be try to maintain that in a material. Okay. The next question is which of the following mechanism is or are temperature dependent. So here the electronic polarization or ionic polarization or both electronic as well as ionic polarization or the orientation polarization. So here the temperature dependent is your orientation polarization. Orientation polarization mechanism, it is temperature dependent. It is not depend on the temperature, that is electronic polarization, ionic polarization. They will not depend on the temperature, but the orientation polarization, it will depend on the temperature. The next question is, which of the following polarization arises due to the alignment of the random molecules? So because of the alignment of the random molecules, which of the following polarization arises? Electronic, orientation, ionic or spacious? So here the correct answer will be orientation polarization. The next question is the electronic polarization alpha e of a monoatomic gas atom is. So the electronic polarization, that is alpha e of a monoatomic gas atom is, this is your 4 pi epsilon naught into r cube. Okay. Then the next question, the ionic polarization, whether it decreases with temperature or increase with the temperature, or it may increase or decrease with the temperature, or it is independent of the temperature. So here the ionic polarization, it is independent of the temperature, it will not depend on the temperature. The next question is, with the increase in the temperature, the orientation polarization in general, it increases or decreases, or is constant, or fast increase then become the constant. So in case of the orientation polarization, with the increase in the temperature, so it will decreases. So with the increase in temperature, the orientation polarization decreases. The next question is the dielectric constant of an insulator may be, this is your 3. Okay, for the insulator, the dielectric constant is 3. The next question is, which of the following is non-zero for vacuum? So, for the vacuum, permittivity is non-zero. Okay. The rest of the quantity, that is the conductivity of heat or the conductivity of electricity, it is 0 for the vacuum. The next question is, Clausius-Mossetti's equation is the relation between, this is the relation between the polarizability and the dielectric constant. Because you know, for the Clausius-Mossetti's relation, this is n alpha by 3 epsilon naught, that is equal to epsilon r minus 1 divided by epsilon r plus 2. This is your Clausius-Mossetti's relation. This alpha is a electronic polarizability, and this epsilon r, this is your dielectric constant, that is this epsilon r can be replaced as k. Okay. The next question is, which of the following is not a component of polarizability? So the options are volume polarizability, space charge polarizability, orientational polarizability, or ionic polarizability. So it is not a component of polarizability. Okay. So the volume polarizability is not a component of polarizability. The rest, that is the space charge, ionic, as well as the orientational polarizability, these are the component of the polarizability. The next is, out of all four known polarization mechanism, which requires maximum electrostatic energy to be supplied is space charge polarization, ionic polarization, or orientational polarization, or electronic polarization. So here the correct answer is electronic polarization. So electronic polarization, it requires maximum electrostatic energy. The next question is, the dielectric medium, it should have property high dielectric constant, high dielectric strength, high specific resistance, or all. So here the dielectric medium, it should have all these properties. Okay, that is, it should have high dielectric constant, it should have high dielectric strength, as well as high specific resistance. The next question is, electronic polarizability of an atom, it is proportional to, so electronic polarizability of an atom, it is proportional to your radius power 3, that is radius cube. Okay. The next question is, choose the correct relation for the orientation polarizability. So for the orientation polarizability, 3kT divided by P square. The next is, the electric field which a dipole experiences in a medium is called the local field, or called the internal field, or equal to the external field, or both local as well as the internal field. So the electric field which a dipole experiences in a medium. Okay, so this will be your, it may be the local field as well as the internal field. So both are true. It is a local field as well as the internal field. Next question is, expression for the internal field, that is your Lorentz field, is given by, so the Lorentz field, you know, this is your EI equal to E plus P by 3 epsilon naught. This is your Lorentz field or the internal field. The last question is, Clausius-Mossetti's equation with the usual meaning of notations can be written. So the correct answer is this one, because you know n alpha divided by 3 epsilon naught equal to epsilon r minus 1 divided by epsilon r plus 2. So here I can write alpha will be equal to epsilon r minus 1 divided by epsilon r plus 2, and this n by 3 epsilon naught. So this expression can be written as alpha will be equal to, this is equal to 3 epsilon naught divided by n into epsilon r minus 1 divided by epsilon r plus 2. So this is our correct answer. This is the Clausius-Mossetti's relation, which gives the relation between the electronic polarizability as well as the dielectric constant. Okay. So this is all for today. Thank you all.